There it is, the bald eagle. Right there. I can't believe it. I can't believe I'm getting a bald eagle on camera. I can't believe it. Oh, I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Oh, let's take a good look at it. That's as far as the digital zoom will go. That's it. That's the farthest I can get. It was very tricky getting the tripod aligned there, but I did it. And I apologize for the shakiness of this camera, because this tripod isn't so great. Like, the wind could easily, I mean, it's not windy right now, but if it were windy, it would blow this tripod away. So let's try to observe this bald eagle. I am located in Bordentown, New Jersey, right along the river. Okay, there's actually a railroad tracks that goes this way and this way. Well, I mean, you can't see my hand because I'm filming the eagle right now. But it makes a lot of sounds, and the birds are all used to hearing those sounds. So I don't think this bald eagle will mind me at all talking on the camera right now. So I'm about 1,000 feet away from it. I'm a fair distance away. But there it is. Oh, such an eye-glancing look. Holy crap. Does that eagle... That eagle's really looking at me like crazy. Oh, that eagle is amazing. I can't believe what amazing image I have of this. It really doesn't get any better than this. It really doesn't. So I just got back from a carnival, a big carnival at Amazon. It's the ABE8 Summer Carnival. Yes, and I just came back. It was from 3 to 6. There was lots of food there and games. Although the games were kind of boring, it was like the hoops, we had the, you know, basketball things on one of the air things that bounces on the air thing, whatever it's called. And then we had baseball, which was kind of boring, just hit them on a poster. Like, there's no, like, target or anything. But it's got, like, a batter, and it's got the guy with the glove, you know, that catches the ball. You know, I don't really know anything about sports. Sports isn't really my thing. But I guess the games were okay. Oh yeah, and there was a ride that loops around in circles. Like, a swing, I guess. That kind of goes up in the air a little bit. I actually have a video of that. Although I'm posting it on a different YouTube channel. So there's the gorgeous, gorgeous eagle right there. Like, it's just so cool to be able to see its head like that. I'll never get a perfect video like this again. Not from this kind of distance. And you know, it's cloudy out too, which is the weirdest thing. You know, sometimes you can get really, really good quality on cloudy days. I am grateful for this experience. I truly am. This bald eagle is so majestically amazing. I am just going to continue to film it until it flies away. So I'm using a tripod to film this. I can't really hold the camera for too long. So this tripod was really cheap. It was only like 10 bucks on eBay. Maybe like more, maybe like 15 or something like that. But believe me, it was really cheap. It took me quite a while for me to adjust my camera to get the absolute perfect footage. I mean, I cannot get any better than this. I really can't. This is as good as it gets. So we're just gonna hang out for a while. Just me and this eagle. All right. Yeah, I'm just making sure this thing's recording, yep. So far, I've filmed this for, well, a little more than 5 minutes now. Seems hard to believe because I took like 5 minutes just to adjust my camera. And you really don't have that much time when filming a raptor. Because you might just come at an unfortunate time. You know, it's got all kinds of things going on around it. I actually saw a mockingbird or some other small bird dive bombing this bald eagle right before I started filming. Unfortunately, I did not catch that on camera only because I was trying to find a good location to film this bald eagle, but I was watching it as I was fixing my camera. And, you know, maybe this bald eagle might catch a fish or something while I'm here. Who knows? Or maybe it'll start roosting. I know one thing is there's supposed to be thunderstorms at 8 o'clock. But I'm not too far from the parking lot. I'm maybe like, what, half a mile or so. So if I hear thunder, I should be able to get to my car in a reasonable amount of time. And I'm sure this bald eagle will probably be gone before then too. So it's preening itself. I don't want to like adjust the camera only because it took me a long time to get this to zoom in right. This tripod is not very stable. Like if you just tilt it just like a millimeter or something, like it'll totally get it off frame. But it is cool to see this bald eagle preening. So that means it doesn't mind my presence at all. It's perfectly comfortable with me being here. That's great, huh? Yeah, that's what that means. That is a sign. A sign that, well, I mean, that I can film this bald eagle for as long as I want and it'll still be here. Oh, there it goes again. There goes that bird. I can see it. And the bald eagle's looking at it too. Go away. Don't bother about that bald eagle. You're going to make it fly off. No, 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 no. You're not allowed to do that. Oh, no. Oh, no. No, 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 no. Don't be pestering that bald eagle. Or else I'm going to come after you. Yeah, there's a bird sitting close to where that bald eagle is. I really don't want to do this, but I do have to zoom out a little bit. That way you can see the other bird. So there it is, right there. So you see what it's doing, right? Yeah, so it's on that tree branch close to that bald eagle. And it doesn't like that bald eagle being there. Because that's this bird's tree, not the bald eagle's tree. Okay, so it seems to have flown off, so that's good. Okay, that's good news. Whoops. Let me zoom that back in here. So that's the end of optical zoom. Okay, so after this point, it'll be all digital zoom. So there you go. So I can't seem to tilt this down, because if I do, see what's gonna happen here. See, all footage is going to be lost. See, it only takes a millimeter, I told ya. You see? So it's very far away from me. You see, if I tilt this just a little bit, so you can still see it, okay? See, it's so bad that even if I like tilt it a little bit, it comes out of, okay, there we go. So this is something that only a professional can do. Okay, this isn't something that I can usually do. I don't have like the best tripod in the world, just that everybody knows. I really don't. Once you get this far away from something, it becomes very difficult to be able to get that perfect image. I just have it raised up just a little bit too far. But yeah, I'm maxed out on digital zoom. I'm maxed out on optical zoom. That is the absolute closest I can film it. Majestic creature, I really love you. Oh, so cute. Oh, this bald eagle's a cutie. Oh. Oh. I'd want to tell you what I'd do if I got close to this thing. Oh, I love this bald eagle. Oh, it's so cute, and I love it. Oh, it's so amazing. It's so amazing. It's so amazing. It's so amazing. Oh. Why are you looking at me? Does it just not appreciate me being here? Why? Why? Try to look for fish. I know there's something in the water that you want to catch. For me. Or just for you, doesn't matter. I mean, I love fish. I mean, my grandpa was actually a fisherman. He caught lots of different fish. You know, he always went out to the bay. You know, always caught some good fish over there near the Point Pleasant area is where he usually fished at. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna have to start the recording in 20 more seconds because every 15 minutes the recording stops. Yes, that's just how this camera operates. I don't have any control over that. And I better hurry up and... There's a bald eagle right there. Holy crap. I got a tripod right in here. I can use this. Okay, back to digital zoom again. Oh, crap. Gotta get back in focus here. This is basically what happens every 15 minutes. Grr. My hips are killing me. Well, at least I got that. Just look at those talons. They're so majestically beautiful. They're used for catching fish underwater. Yes, eagles can actually dive underwater. They actually can swim a little bit too. I've actually heard that if a bald eagle has difficulty with a fish, yes, it does happen. They do struggle with them. They can't, you know, and they can't seem to swoop up fast enough above the water. What'll happen is the bald eagle will actually swim, okay? Swim to shore, because it's a lot easier to swim than to fly once it gets too deep, you know what I mean? Let me zoom that out just a little bit. It's better if I just do that. That way you can see the whole eagle. So yeah, very beautiful. Such a beautiful eagle. My mom's gonna love seeing this. Why doesn't anybody think of filming this eagle? Like, I go to ebird.org and I see this park listed, and it's like somebody sees one but not films it. Why? Do they just not have the type of technology like I do? People would rather just use the good old-fashioned binoculars rather than a camera? Hey, that's okay. People still use binoculars. Even when they're not even when they are filming, they use binoculars. I'm not actually looking at the bald eagle on the camera. I'm actually looking with my own eyes at the moment. So if it flies off, I might not react quick enough. And it's 1,000 feet away, so it'd be very hard for me to track this eagle anyways. So brace yourself in case it flies off. I might not be able to get it on camera. That eagle is just too beautiful. I mean, it is amazing. It is a work of nature. Oh, there's a bird. There's a bird close by. It's right there. So it's going from tree branch to tree branch again, pestering this beautiful bald eagle. That's the bird I'm talking about. That one right there. So let's see what it does. You just gonna stand there, or are you gonna try to like act territorial towards that bald eagle? Yeah, you don't really have to do that, you know. You could just find another tree to perch on. You don't have to perch on that tree, you know. Okay, well, it seems like it left, so it's shaking up its feathers. Is it gonna fly off? No, it looks like it's preening itself. It's good news for me. So it looks like one of its feathers is sticking out. Could be molting. That is so beautiful. Like, look at that. Oh, man. It's like flashing its wings like that. Could you imagine if this bald eagle, like, flew right past me? I would probably be able to feel the wind from its wings. If only it did. Although it's more likely going to go to the right because that's where the lake is. Okay, there's no water to the left of me. It's only to the right. All right. I'm gonna film this thing as long as I can. Like, this is just totally lucky. Like, I went to a carnival, I had some fun, played some games, ate some food, and then I came here, and hey, the party's still continuing. Look at that, like, this is a party right here. Like, look at this majestic bald eagle right there. I can't stop thinking about that bald eagle. I really can't. Oh, here comes the train. That was the river line right there that just drove by. So it goes from Trenton to Philly. Yeah. That's the river line right there. So very beautiful. I can just hear the sounds of nature right here. This eagle's still preening itself. I am so happy that it wants to preen right in front of my presence right here. That is a good sign. A sign of hope. A sign that just everything can go right. You know? This is simply amazing. What's going on? Is it gonna take off? Okay, it's still preening itself. That's great, okay. Keep on preening. You can actually tell this is an adult bald eagle because it has its white head feathers. When they're young, it's all brown. So yeah, so this eagle's, well, it's been here for a while. I don't know where its nest is, though. That is a mystery. Haven't seen any raptor nest, no hawk's nest, no eagle's nest, no nothing. Even the eagles at Mercer County Park, I don't see them at the nest over there. There is actually a nest right across the river from the park. And it's still preening. Oh, so beautiful. Oh, yes. I'm just gonna keep going until I run out of batteries. I'll have to replace them if I run out, and then I'm gonna have to reposition my camera again, but I'm sure it'll probably be dark before then. And I don't know how much longer this eagle is gonna stay here. I haven't got a clue. There comes an airplane. Don't know if that airplane's gonna scare it. It's looking right at me. It's looking directly at me. That's crazy. Pressure is on. Ooh, that eye glancing stare is scary. Staring at me again, huh? Why do you stare at me so? Why? crap, what's going on? I'm losing focus. Everything was so great before. Oh, maybe it's because of the train. Electrical interference, perhaps? That's my best guess. Yeah, if I lose focus for too long, I'm not going to be able to do this recording. Alright, running out of recording. Gotta press record button again. Alright, so there's my lovely bald eagle here. As the sun sets, it's going to be harder to get good footage. So I apologize for the shakiness. This camera tripod is so flimsy. It's just plastic. It'll actually shake in a mild breeze. Don't have any control over that. There's one thing I need to do. I need to switch to the screen instead of the... Alright, I'm recording now. Again. There we go, okay. The only problem with this camera is even the slightest tilt, you lose everything. Keep in mind that I'm going into digital zoom now. It's not like before when I was using optical zoom. But this bald eagle is majestic. So I flipped up my screen so that that way I can sit down and film this. I might just lay down on the grass. don't be losing focus now. Don't be losing focus. Oh, I think there's a train coming again. I knew it. For some reason, every time a train comes, it goes out of focus. Yeah, I don't know why. It's coming. Or maybe not. Bald eagle's looking at me again. Why do you stare? Actually laying down right now. Yeah. I'm like a stranded fish on a dirt trail. Well, hopefully the eagle doesn't think that. Otherwise, I'd be the eagle's dick. Is it gonna go? Oh, it's bothered by that stupid bird again. That one. That's the one I'm talking about. That one right there. see, is it still there? Yeah, it's still bothering it. And what's funny is the bird leaves, okay? The eagle's still there. Then the bird just comes back and, you know, just kind of ignores it. You can see the bald eagle's preening up, doesn't really care what's going on around it. Oh. There it goes again. Yeah, I don't even see it, but it just like comes back like really quickly, that bird. I don't think it's on the tops of those branches, I don't think so. Zoom out a little bit. Enjoy the I'm about to run out of footage again. Gotta press the record button again. Crap, I didn't bring a spare battery. Well, once I run out of battery power, this is it. I know I got a battery here somewhere. Oh, thank the stars, I do. I'm just getting it out right now, that way I'm prepared. Just in case this eagle does stay there longer. I'm a guy that loves footage. I can't stand it when people make footage so short, but yet I like to make them so long. Only because I don't get too close to these raptors. I keep my distance. so they don't notice me. And the less they notice me, the more footage I'll get. Seagull came from a different area. It was just here temporarily. Been able to record a raptor this long since I recorded the Merlin back in January. Can't believe it's been that long since I last made a long video like this. And that Merlin is very close to me. This eagle's further. But because this eagle's so huge, I could really get some good footage from far away. Especially with my digital zoom turned on. I finally figured out how to turn it back on. I initially left it off because I know that you're not supposed to take bird photographs with digital zoom. It just doesn't look professional. But this looks pretty good. I'm really satisfied with this. And that applies to photographs, not videos. This is a video. But raptors are way cooler. Raptors are way cooler than any dumb songbird. But there is always a balance in nature. Yes, the songbirds are important in nature. Very important.
bald eagle's gonna fly off any minute now. It's not gonna stay on that tree, I just know it won't. It could be wrong though. But I don't think it's gonna roost there. I should have worn bug spray. I should have. I hate bugs.
Uh-oh. Is it gonna go? Beautiful, majestic eagle. You're gonna fly off, I know it. I just know it's gonna fly off. I'm waiting. Not yet. Okay. Man, these mosquitoes or gnats, whatever they are, is really bothering me. But I zoom back in again. I just ran out of ran out of minutes on the recording.
ruckus like crazy. Must be a training helmet. I don't know what causes that problem. Like, that's just the weirdest thing. Coming to focus, stupid bird. Come on, going to focus. I hope it's not the end of the recording.
Possible that eagle wants to roost there. Dark. Somebody just went by the camera. Yeah, once it gets this dark, it's gonna be tough to get footage.
Nope, I'll just leave it just like that. We're losing him. Reception fading. We're losing reception. Better call the receptionist. Nah. Yeah, one thing's for sure, the Nikon P900 does have its limitations. And focus capabilities are one of them. Oh, there it goes again. Oh. So what do you think? You think that eagle's just gonna roost there overnight? I think so.
yeah, once it gets this dark, I think recording a raptor is completely and utterly pointless. I think there is a way to switch to nighttime mode. I don't know if that's gonna help. And I'll probably lose footage before I even, you know, before I'm able to do that sort of thing. I highly doubt this eagle can see me. I don't think so. I'm too close to the bushes. I wonder if this eagle is still preening. It looks like it's just frozen. Frozen in time and space. I'll try not to talk too loudly because I might disturb the eagle. This eagle might actually be sleeping right now. Yeah, it's very true. So there is the eagle. You can see it oh so faintly. The problem is I can't zoom in. You see, it completely gets cropped out. So I have to zoom out further. Did it again. I think I'll stop there. Can I go to the menu settings possibly? Nope, it won't let me go to the menu settings while I record this. Let me try to record it at a different... Yeah, that's crazy, huh? Well, I'm out of here. I'm gonna let this eagle slumber.